There's a reasoning behind it. So I want you to make sure when you write down that action, you understand that there's a reason behind it. Isn't just buying car. Isn't just getting cha-cha dancing buses, okay? Just to emphasize. Second thing, what do I mean by capturing the major steps of the journey? You see, first part, start all the way from the beginning. Realize the need that I need to learn how to cha-cha. Then the second stage, search around for classes on Google. I definitely won't ask my friends, because I don't want my friends to know. People think, oh, you want to learn about dancing, definitely you ask your friends, hey, you know any dancing classes nearby? But this one is a different case, because your user is different. Not every journey will be the same for everyone, because there's definitely a reason behind it. A lot of teams here, they choose last time going on a trip. Are you sure all of their trips are the same? Are you sure they'll go through all the exact same thing? Yes, they'll definitely be similar, because no matter what, you still have to go from point A to point B. That one is the definition of a trip. But there's a reasoning behind it, and this is how you know, right? What are the major phases? Third one, visit dancing studios and talk to trainers. The fourth stage, come back another day to attend the first class, or trial class, right? Then only the fifth stage, actually going home. Have I bought the classes yet? No, because I only want to find cha-cha dancing classes.
Okay.
There's a dot there.
That's actually the major steps.
Oh,
so we
okay.
Identify those major steps.
Oh, okay, okay.
So to bring out all the actual steps.
I see. Okay, thanks.
Alright, everyone okay?
Thanks.
Got your major steps down already, yeah? Alright. So, starting from A and ending up in C, to seeing that they are actually just not just a timeline, but major steps and phases. So you can see what you just list down, either 5, 4, 5, or 6, I see some of you put under 6, is that these are the top, okay? There's many, many things that they do inside. This is the timeline, right? Timeline is just from A to Z. Now, you see, from A to Z, they're doing many, many different things, but all of these are encompassed under a stage. Okay. Everyone, you've written down your left side. You'll be doing this exercise alone. Means, after you've written everything down, you'll the last key paste it down first. So, after you paste down everything ready, from now onwards, for the next
exercise. Okay, so, I'll shout louder so you can hear. Okay.
Okay.
Now, I want you all to know that thinking is about the thoughts in your user's mind. At the current stage right now, let's say if their stage is realizing they need to buy iPad for example, their thought is, which one is better, Android or iOS? What do I need the iPad for? What do I need the tablet for? So all these are questions inside your user's mind that are currently their thinking. Most of the time, thinking is in the form of questions. Like, for example, what car should I buy? If you go try, just write one down, just to give it a try, so see you understand. If you don't understand, just ask any of the facilitators for him to help.
Okay? Oh my god. Okay, thank you.
The main reason why you want to know emotions is that they are emotional. So definitely they are not like that. So, see by the body language. I know it's a bit difficult, but just rethink back to the time when you interviewed, were they happy? Were they leaning in? Were they leaning back? Were they feel very defensive or were they very happy explaining it? So think of it. All of these things are good indicators. Your one looks readable, so to speak. Put it nicely. For those that are already organized, it's okay, you can leave it. And I congratulate you. Okay. So just put it together, keep it, just organize it nicely. Don't need to add new things with it.
Okay. Judgment time. You got 5 minutes.
Agree, yeah?
Please, for the original team,
okay.
Please share your map. Please share your map, okay?
and then have your interviewees give goal of this step. Why ask the interviewees to come back? Okay?
Agree,
calm down. Okay, before you start. Before you start talking. The reason why you're doing this ugly map or whatever you created is because you want to make sure and you want to get their feedback. There are very often times you have assumptions and then you're guessing or maybe you're just thinking maybe it's like this. But these are all your own experiences. It might be share you their map right now, they have to write down the feedback. The original team, the one that interviewed you, they have to write down because they get feedback, they don't know if it's correct or not. Capture down the feedback. Okay, everyone, hold on for a while. Okay. I'm hearing a bit something like this. Let's say, hold on, everyone, listen up. So what I'm getting from everyone is this, you know. What I'm getting from everyone is this. Let's say I'm the one being interviewed. I say, oh no lah, this map, this part, I don't really feel this way. The interviewer say, no lah, I confirm you feel this way. I definitely know, I know how you feel. I know how you think, I know what you're doing.
This, don't do that, I try to
influence
this.
Why you confiscate, huh?
Yeah, confiscate.